Hey guys, Ewan here, and in this video, the topic is Carlos Thomas, the NPC Nationals overall winner, and that's gonna be one topic. The other, more broad topic is going to be the direction of bodybuilding. So, first, this guy is an absolute freak. To be honest, I didn't really follow this guy before the NPC Nationals, and when I saw the photos and the videos, yeah, I realized that he's really big, that he has really big and full legs, crazy chest and stuff like that. He's very big and round, but I didn't really see him beating, for example, Justin Shire, who was completely shredded. Carlos Thomas did not showcase such conditioning. But then, when you look at, for example, this video right here, you can see Justin Shire right here. He looks good, like he is very wide. He stands out in this lineup, with muscularity, with conditioning, with shoulder width, with size overall, but look at Carlos Thomas and look at the legs. So look at the legs difference. Yeah, he has the angle, the difference is not really that big, you're gonna see a comparison in the lineup in a moment, but still, you can see that Justin looks a little bit too stringy compared to this tank of a bodybuilder, Carlos Thomas. So it's definitely not conditioning or shape why Carlos Thomas won. The reason is simply mass. He was bigger, rounder, more massive, and he deserved this victory for sure. Look at the legs. Super full, super crazy round. This guy's a freak. In this lineup comparison of the overall, you can see the difference. You can see what I'm talking about. So it's not the shape, it's not the structure, it's simply the mass that got Carlos Thomas this win. And I think he deserved it because of the sheer mass. It was simply overwhelming. It was too much for him to lose this show. Justin Shire also got a pro card, by the way, by winning his class. And this guy has a lot of potential, but to be competitive against guys like this mass monster, Carlos Thomas here, he needs to bring up the mass. He needs to come in bigger, fuller, rounder, especially in the lower body. Not so long ago, a couple of years back, 2018, Sean Roden won the Mr. Olympia. And everybody felt like the direction of bodybuilding was changed. So many people thought that the criteria is different now, that what is looked for is a small waist, aesthetic physique, not just sheer mass, roundness, freakiness, but the pretty lines, the small waist, the good shape and structure and stuff like that, which is something that Sean Roden was representing. 10 years before this, 2008, Dexter Jackson beat Jay Cutler. Again, a smaller guy with prettier structure, small waist and stuff like that, was able to beat a mass monster. And everybody thought, even back then, that bodybuilding took a different direction. It wasn't true then, it wasn't true 2018, and it's not true today. Mass is the priority in open bodybuilding. It is. It's not conditioning, it's not pretty lines. Conditioning can be overlooked, and that happens very often, but mass, no. If you are smaller, significantly smaller than the guy next to you, and you have better conditioning than him, it doesn't matter in open bodybuilding. The bigger guy will win. We saw that at the amateur level right now. The guy that won was the most massive, he wasn't the most conditioned. But apparently that's what the judges want for the open division, they want big freaks. We saw the same thing at the Mr. Olympia at the highest level. Instead of Hari Chopin winning because he had the best conditioning on that stage and was also very big, very complete, but the bigger guy won. Big Ramy was simply overwhelming with his size. He was just too much, you know, and that's open bodybuilding. It is mass. So Big Ramy beat Hari Chopin. Now I can go back in time and talk about 2017 when Big Ramy was second and Phil was first. Even though Ramy was bigger, but that wasn't that big of a difference as far as size. Yeah, Big Ramy was a bigger man, but Phil probably packed more muscle on his frame. Phil is simply a little bit more narrow, but on his frame he packed a ton of muscle and it was just freaky, bubbly, 3D looking. So of course he won, but that does not change the fact that open bodybuilding requires a ton of mass. And that's why I think Carlos Thomas is going to do very well in a professional league as an open bodybuilder, because he is that freaky. The improvements that Carlos Thomas made from 2017 until today are significant. He grew so much muscle in only 4 years. If he made this much progress in 4 years, how much more progress will he make in the next 4 years? So, I mean, he doesn't need more mass, you know, he needs more mass in the back, that's it. As far as the front area, nothing really. I don't like his abs too much. They have that separation in the middle like Ronnie Coleman used to have and some other bodybuilders. But that really won't hurt him that much in open bodybuilding because, as I said, the aesthetics are not really that big of a factor. Mass and freakiness most certainly is, and this guy has it. Look at the legs. I mean, this guy has such round legs. They're forming a freaking circle. And then the arms are big, the shoulders are freaky, and that chest is just ridiculous. So I'm really curious to see how well will he do when he does an open bodybuilding show, and I'm really curious how much more progress can he make. As far as mass, once again, he really doesn't have to do a lot more work, but he needs to get more polished, you know, he needs to work on details, more conditioning, stuff like that. So with time, I'm sure he'll make a ton of progress, and with being this freaky, this massive already, when he already turned pro, I think there is a bright future ahead of this guy in open bodybuilding, if everything goes well with health, because these big guys, you know, that they are risking a lot. They are not at their healthiest, for sure, when they are at this size, so we know that. But if everything goes well, if he stays healthy, if he stays motivated, nothing really happens bad, and I hope nothing will, if everything goes by the plan, I believe this guy, with these genetics, with this much muscle, can be one of the top guys at the Mr. Olympia in a couple of years, maybe even sooner. What do you guys think? Does he have the potential to actually be in the top at the Mr. Olympia? Can he win pro shows? I think he can. I think he is that freaky. There are guys that crack the top 10 at the Mr. Olympia that are nothing compared to him as far as mass, like Patrick Moore, for example. I think this guy is way freakier, way more impressive as a bodybuilder than Patrick Moore. So I'm really curious to see what he will do when he competes next time as a pro. If you guys like this video, please give it a thumbs up. For more bodybuilding content like this, subscribe to my channel. Thank you so much guys for watching. All the best and bye bye.